Welcome to the new series of lectures which is about documentation platform called LaTeX. In this lecture, you will learn the introduction to LaTeX, how it works, the difference between LaTeX and Microsoft Word, and different LaTeX platforms to work on. LaTeX is an open source documentation software that has the ability to organize text, figures, plots, tables, etc. in a very uniform way. For example, you do not have to worry about each and every heading individually. Just give a command, define everything you want to define about that heading, and that's it. It will go all the way and format every heading according to your defined settings. LaTeX has a very beautiful bibliography support. You know, every journal and every university has their own customized bibliography styles. But you do not have to worry about. LaTeX can help you out and ease your process of preparing bibliography styles. Just define the style in LaTeX and leave the rest to it. It will format the references according to your defined style by itself. Have you noticed while reading a thesis or a book, the pages in the start and at the end or the first page of every chapter has totally different formatting styles, which is different from rest of the document. Structuring a document is also very easy here, whether it is to write an abstract or acknowledgement, or maybe the structuring within the pages or figures. LaTeX will do it very easily. You prepared a document but you didn't like the formatting of your document. No worries. LaTeX is so easy that you can change any formatting, whether it is the font of level 1 heading or it is the vertical space between a chapter title and the first paragraph of that chapter or anything else. LaTeX will do it with just a couple of commands and your whole document will be turned into new settings. All of us know Microsoft Word very well. Well, the Microsoft Word has very beautiful interface with a lot of buttons and functionalities. But the LaTeX is not that much beautiful and it does not have any GUI based software, except here everything works on the basis of commands. One who learns how to use LaTeX will not turn to Microsoft Word again if he or she really wants to format the document in a perfect way. Microsoft Word has the advantage of GUI, but this GUI does not help in formatting a document. Almost all of us once lost the formatting of page number 10 while trying to format page number 11 of a document. With Microsoft Word, while preparing a document, for example, you are willing to start a new chapter. What are the steps you need to do for it? Insert a new page, type the chapter heading, match the title font with the desired one, match the spacings above and below the title, make sure it is added to table of contents, and a lot more, including special formatting for the first page of a chapter in every document. But in LaTeX, just use the command \chapter and here you go. Everything will be configured according to the predefined chapter settings. Is it easy to change the formatting of already formatted document in Microsoft Word? I'm sure you will mess the whole thing up and down. LaTeX will do it in a very simple way. For example, you didn't like the title font, use the command for title font and change it in a single line. No need to do it individually for every title in the whole document. Similarly, the formatting of the whole document can also be changed to a new available template using just a couple of commands. In Microsoft Word, you need to double check everything that whether everything is perfect according to the template or not. There is a big chance of disturbing the formatting of previous pages while trying to format the new pages. LaTeX will not let you worry about that. You define the format and it will go all the way and will be applied perfectly. And the formatting will not be disturbed again. Unlike Microsoft Word, there is no graphical user interface in LaTeX where you will click and go. In order to use LaTeX, you generate a file containing both the text that you wish to print and the instructions to tell LaTeX how you want that text to appear in the document. You will normally create this file using the system's text editor. You can give the file any name you like, but the extension should be .txt to identify the file's contents. You then get the LaTeX to process the file and it creates a new file of typesetting commands. This has the same name as your file, but the .txt extension is replaced by .dvi, This stands for device independent, and as the name implies, this file can be used to create output of different extension, including PDF, which is the most used one. There is a misconception about LaTeX that it is meant for only computer science personnels or those who knows programming. LaTeX is an open source software and it is very easy to learn. There are a variety of online and offline softwares available for LaTeX. In offline softwares, sometimes you have to manually download a new package for a specific command, place it into working directory, and then you are able to use it. Although it is not a difficult part, but sometimes a new package needs a lot of new files that have to be downloaded manually and used. There comes a difficult part. That is why I prefer to use online LaTeX platforms which are totally free and there is no need to download any package here. Just type the command and rest will be done by the LaTeX automatically. I'll be going to use online LaTeX platform called Overleaf in my lectures. My lectures will mostly target the persons who does not know programming so that their documents can also be formatted perfectly using LaTeX. This was the introduction to LaTeX. In the coming lectures, I will teach you how to start writing a document in Overleaf. Till then, take care and do not forget to subscribe this channel. See you in next lectures. Thank you.